I'll never forget what he told me during that interview. He said that working at the White House was like trying to drink water through a fire hose at full throttle. And he was right. 9/11, the war in Afghanistan, the war in Iraq, the shuttle Columbia disaster, funerals for two presidents and a pope, another close presidential election that wasn't decided that night, the worst U.S. natural disaster in history, the worst economic crisis since the Great Depression. And there's actually a joke running around the West Wing that the next thing that would happen would be aliens landing on the South Lawn, but luckily that didn't happen. And then the president actually spoke to me right after I made this picture, and he said, "Eric, are you interested in history?" And all I could say was, "Yes, sir." And he said, "These pictures you're taking are very important, the one in the Situation Room and the one here on the South Lawn." And just as he said that, out of the corner of my eye, Secretary of Defense Don Rumsfeld and Vice President Cheney came walking out of the Oval Office, and the president walked over to greet them, and they're discussing the start of the timing of the war in Iraq. One untold story is how many times the president would meet with the injured, would go to hospitals, just dozens of trips to Walter Reed, to Bethesda. Anytime he would travel around the country, he would visit with the troops to meet the families of the fallen, and those were powerful moments too, like this moment here at Walter Reed Hospital after presenting this soldier who was injured in Afghanistan with the Purple Heart. I think what I'll miss the most about my job is traveling on Air Force One. I mean, that was a cool way to see the world. I mean, nothing compares. I mean, it never got old for all 8 years, and I kind of wish I would have been able to get air miles, but the government doesn't work that way.